trust is vital to the health of any relationship. When you trust another person, you enable him to feel safe and accepted. This feeling of safety and acceptance must be present if people are to produce their best work. When people feel trusted, they are free to concentrate all their efforts on the job instead of worrying about how they are going to justify their actions. When they don't feel trusted, they live in constant fear of fulfilling your negative expectations. And managers who are basically untrusting usually make snap judgments based on outward appearances. They don't take time to gather the facts and objectively evaluate situations. Consequently, the people who work for them spend enormous amounts of time and energy manipulating outward appearances, since that is all that matters. They constantly try to head off problems at the pass, problems that in many cases are nothing more than the manager's misperceptions. When you trust another person, you help to build his confidence and self-esteem. And people who have low self-esteem usually don't trust themselves to do well. All too often, their lack of self-trust is unfounded. Many people are capable and have good instincts, but because of prior conditioning, they live in webs of self-doubt and anxiety. Sometimes, all it takes is the trust of another person for a person to learn to trust himself. The manager who says, "It's okay, I believe you, I believe you can do it, I trust you." This gives the person the courage and confidence he needs to take the risk. If this is done repeatedly for a person over time, he will eventually learn to trust himself. He will come to have a realistic view of his own talents and abilities. And when we talk about trusting a person, we are referring to two types of trust. Number one, trust in the person's character and integrity. Number two, trust in the person's abilities. A person may be of the highest integrity, but his abilities may not match his character. He may sincerely want to act in the best interest of the job and company, but he may not be able to because of some deficiencies in skills and abilities. In other cases, a person may be fully capable of doing the job, but his motives and desires, which may be less than pure, will keep him from using his talents and abilities wisely. Usually, the former is easier to deal with. It is easier to give a person a new skill than it is to give him character. On relationship and the relationship process, you will have to determine how much enter the person. As you determination, be sure to draft both criteria. Keep them separate in your mind so that you will have a realistic view of the person. Have a great day.